Wensan Road. It's one of the most crowded streets in Hangzhou. The spring of 2008 saw heavy roadworks on Wensan Road. For Alibaba's employees, the morning commute required dodging construction equipment, enduring tailbacks, and navigating construction that surrounded the Huaxing Venture Building. Down on Wensan Road East, the employees of NetSun, working in the Yisheng Building, arrived at their offices and cubicles covered with the dust and detritus of development. Wen Nan Dao walks to work every day, and the rhythms of Wensan Road are, and have always been, a part of his life. 15 years ago, it was farmland. Now, it is a thoroughfare dedicated to the IT industry's top names. Wen owns 6 buildings here, homes for his ego IT chain retail outlets.
我呢前面有一个中大的这边有一个这块地这个楼然后把它连起来这里3栋楼然后背后还有一栋楼背后也是我的那么这块呢是以后的主力我就把它叫成IT社区IT社区呢以IT为核心然后再稍微再发散一下
There are more than 2,000 individual booths at Wen's Ego department store. The vendors here peddle computer accessories and digital products. And every day, old vendors withdraw and new vendors join. The examples of Sun Denan and Wen Nan Dao, IT stars who started their businesses on Wensan Road, are part of the pulse of this part of town. But if there's a local IT superhero, it is Ma Yun. More than merely an example to his own employees, Jack Ma inspires IT employees everywhere. In Zhejiang, no place has gathered more IT talent than Hangzhou's Wensan Road. And if Zhejiang has a miniature Silicon Valley, this is it.
其实全中国省会或者主要城市都有像文山街这样的一个区域一高校特别集中第二应该不是城市的主流区块第三这个环境的成本相对来说比较低然后呢这帮很穷酸有思想的人呢就集聚在这个地方其实最初都是这样其实你去看 90年的时候 文山街就是一片荒凉 就那种感觉，然后这个地方的街最破，人最穷，楼最差，都是这属于这种。那么后面呢，这个周围当然浙大肯定是其主要作用，杭大、浙大、吉林学院这里啊，一批大学。那么尊重知识年代以后，邓小平这个改革开放以后啊，起来以后，那这里肯定是属于高校集聚区啊。高校集聚区以后有人嘛，有人气。
1993, Wen rented a booth at the intersection of Wensan Road and Jiaogong Road. After graduating from Zhejiang University as a computer science major, Wen, unlike his classmates, did not choose to be a technician. After working for 5 years in municipal government, he set his sights on going into business.
我们88年毕业的时候呢，刚好遇到改革开放第二波。 所以这个第二个呢，就是我们这个IT行业，这个行业比较新颖一些，所以它比较适合于当时在当时这个环境上面的创业。当时我记得我们毕业以后，88年毕业，有很多部分的人去这个深圳，去深圳。那么深圳一般呢，去也去一些国有企业，但是深圳这个IT类的企业的创业比较多。 所以后面慢慢开始到90年开始这个浙江这边内地的这个IT方面的这个创业就相对来说门槛比较低吧，门槛比较低。那么我呢是浙大毕业以后，到了先分到省物资局，然后过了几年以后才下海的。所以这个我觉得这个要说IT创业，一门槛比较低，第二氛围。你看同学当中谁又创业了，然后就来拉你，你肯定也去，对吧？就这种。<笑>
In 1993, Ma Yun was still a teacher at Hangzhou Normal University. He He opened up an agency to facilitate foreign language communications and translations, but his e-commerce platform was still years away. In 1993, there wasn't much internet around, and Sun Deliang was still a college student with limited chances to connect with computers. At that time, in China, UC-DOS and WPS were installed in almost every single computer. These were the Microsoft Windows of the day. Few knew that the most useful software available was in fact developed by two Zhejiangese. Qiu Bojun from Xinqiang in Zhejiang province is a software programming engineer with a strong reputation. Every computer installed with WPS showed his name when booted up. His work provides work for hundreds of thousands of typists in China. Bao Yuqiao graduated from Hangzhou University, just down the road from Wensan Road, in 1989. At first, he worked in a rubber factory. The UC-DOS program he wrote in this factory once accounted for 90% of the domestic software share.
我就花了一个礼拜的时间就写了一个反编译系统。其实就说在当时的这个市场上，这样一个反编译系统，可能是就说是非常有价值。如果我比如说发现的早，如果去做，说不定那个可以赚上百万的。
UC-DOS was indeed run on every computer in China, something that brought overnight fame to Bao Yuqiao, for whom the rubber factory offered too small a stage for Bao's talent. At that time, Zhongguancun High Tech Park in Beijing was the holy land of China's IT industry, and in 1993, Bao left Hangzhou to run his Beijing Hope Software Company Limited in Zhongguancun. The IT industry of the 1990s can be contemplated as the age of the individual hero, and often the hero was a programmer who could both write code and set up a company. Two of Zhejiang's IT legends had the same experience. In the middle 1990s, when foreign software was entering China, Bao's UC-DOS was forced out of the market, while Qiu's WPS was struggling to stay alive. 1993. Unsuccessful in his competition with Microsoft, Zhu Ming sold his Future Labs for $12 million. Zhu's WebEx, which would one day challenge Microsoft, didn't yet exist. In that same year, 1993, Ding Lei graduated from Chengdu University of Science and Technology. He worked first in local government in Ningbo as an engineer, and later moved to Guangzhou, where he would do business. Chen Tianqiao from Zhejiang Xinqiang graduated from Fudan University and worked in Shanghai Lujiazui Finance and Trade Zone. These two young men could not imagine that one day their names would appear on the list of the richest men in China.
我非常希望在自己所擅长的领域，在自己能够看得到未来的一个目标上去努力了。尽管在这个94年，我看到互联网这个没有什么商业机会可言在中国，对吧？但
1997. The internet has now entered the homes of many urban families in China. Ding Lei in Guangzhou set up his NetEase website with 500,000 yuan. It is now one of the three largest portals in China today.
我们当初成立企业的公司的时候，不是想做一个门户网站，也没有这个门户网站的概念。我们只是说想做一个软件，然后卖给别人。 啊，那这个门户网站，包括后来我们很快接触到风险投资等等，都是我们在发展过程中不断学习了解到的，对吧？那门户网站做着做着做到2001年，发现嘛都不灵光，都不赚钱。这个其实我觉得作为一个老板是心里很难过的一件事情，对吧？你出门了，人家说跟你聊起来，哎，哥们你在干嘛？兄弟你干嘛？啊，我开网易。哎，你去年挣多少钱？不好意思，我去年亏200万美金。我操，那你还好意思在这里吃饭，对吧？但我就觉得，就是说那时候你要知道，做互联网谁不亏钱谁不烧钱，感觉就傻子一样，对吧？但我觉得这个观念是一定错误。所以网易很快的在2001年过了泡沫以后，在2002年、2003年调整过来。我记得是2002年，我们就挣了30万美元的净利润，啊，一个公司，网易2002年30万美元的净利润，你觉得很搞笑？但是那时候我们已经很自豪，为什么呢？整个行业没有一家赚钱，就我们一家赚钱，第一家赚钱，很自豪。
2003，NetEase listed on Nasdaq. Ding was worth $7.6 billion, which listed him among the top rich of China. Ding majored in technology, and NetEase started with technology. They created plenty of firsts in China's internet history. The first Chinese full-text search engine, the first free high-capacity individual blog base,the first free e-cards site, the first virtual community, the first latest products online web auction, and the first Chinese personal service. NetEase was twice listed as the top website according to CNNIC's list of the nation's top 10 websites. On August 10, 2004, Senda posted its financial statements.The value of Chen Tianqiao stocks reached $9 billion, surpassing Ding's. In 2005, with $15 billion in assets, Chen became the richest man in China. 32 years old, 5 years effort, and a net worth of $15 billion.Leaving his first job at a securities firm and counting on the bull market of 1999, Chen Tianqiao accumulated $500,000 and established his Senda. Senda began with virtual community games. In the spring of 2001, Korea Actos's boss released his game, Legend, in China and was searching for a network operator.Chen took the risk and spent $300,000, everything he had, to buy the licensing authority for the game's China operation. Chen's investment seemed to pay off. He soon enjoyed command of 60% of the China online game market.
实际上我是在一个正确的时机做了一件，按照我的这个想法做了一件事情。那么财富呢，就像自己的副产品。就是说，实际上我并不是为了追求财富而来的，我可能就是说我享受工作，我享受生活，享受工作当中解决问题那种快乐。但是呢，财富因为你的解决问题而不断的增长，所以别人就会认为说财富的增长是一个传奇。像在我心目当中，我觉得这并不是，可能普通人眼光当中这是传奇，在我眼光当中，我只是做了我爱做的事情。
The efforts of Ding and Chen triggered the emergence of China's portal era and online game era, but.Back now to Wensan Road. In 1999, Ma Yuing founded Alibaba out of his home in Hangzhou. Like Chen, his starting capital was $500,000. Since Alibaba's 1999 listing on the Hong Kong Stock Exchange, Wensan has become something of a yellow brick road. The story continues next time.